गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ चैप्टर एयर अराउंड अस। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एयर एंड इट्स कंपोजिशन। लेट्स प्रोसीड अहेड। एज वी ऑल नो, लाइक लैंड एंड वाटर, एयर इज ऑल्सो सिग्निफिकेंट फॉर आर लाइफ। वी कैन नॉट एग्जिस्ट इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एयर। इन फैक्ट इट इज अ बेसिक सोर्स फॉर आर ब्रीदिंग सिस्टम। एयर इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेज दैट सराउंड्स द अर्थ। वी कैन नॉट परसीव एयर when it is calm, but it can be felt when the air is in motion. This total mass of air surrounding our earth is known as the atmosphere. It is found that up to an altitude of 90 kilometers from the earth's surface, the proportion of three major gases present in the atmosphere is uniform. These major gases are nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon dioxide. But above 90 kilometer, the composition begins to change due to increase in the proportion of lighter gases like helium. Apart from these gases, the air also contains some amount of dust particles and water vapors. Let us understand the importance of each of these constituents in the atmosphere. First, we will discuss nitrogen. Its concentration is higher in the atmosphere, that is about 78%. It means nitrogen occupies 78% of the total volume in the air. It is thus the most plentiful gas, but has little direct importance to living organism. When we inhale air, a major amount of nitrogen is not utilized inside our body system. On the contrary, plants absorb nitrogen through the soil. This is used by plants to support their growth and development. Thus, nitrogen is indirectly useful to us. Nitrogen is lighter than oxygen and carbon dioxide. Nitrogen is a tasteless, colorless, and odorless gas that retards combustion. It means the process of burning. It is difficult to control fire without nitrogen. It means it is nitrogen that dilutes oxygen and prevents rapid burning at the earth's surface. Now we will discuss about oxygen. About nitrogen, it is the second most plentiful gas in the atmosphere. It is heavier than nitrogen while lighter than carbon dioxide. Its concentration is about 21% in the atmosphere. Oxygen is also called the life gas, as it is the basis of life for all organisms including human beings. It means all living organisms whether human beings or animals inhale oxygen from the surrounding air to stay alive. Thus, oxygen is known as life supporting gas. The atmosphere is continuously replenished of oxygen by the green plants through the process of photosynthesis, and this keeps a healthy balance of oxygen in the air. Therefore, growing of trees and bushes is very important to maintain a balance of oxygen supply in the air. Now come in carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is the heaviest gas of the atmosphere. It is highly variable gas of the atmosphere because its concentration always varies with the variability of the level of pollution. Its concentration is about 0.03% in the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide is essential for the growth of plants because they prepare food with its help. Carbon dioxide keeps the atmosphere warm by absorbing sun's rays. It is also used by the plants to release oxygen. Human beings and animals release carbon dioxide and inhale oxygen to stay alive. The amount of absorbed carbon dioxide by the plants seems to be equal to the amount released by the human beings and animals. This makes a perfect balance in our environment. But its balance is disturbing day to day because the factories, industries, vehicles, etc. are adding a huge amount of pollutants in it. This imbalance is adversely affecting Earth's weather and climate and our day-to-day lives. If the amount of carbon dioxide is more in the air, it can adversely affect the living beings. It is because, as we all know, the carbon dioxide has a property to absorb heat. It increases temperature of the atmosphere, which in turn increases the temperature over the Earth's surface. This is cause of global warming, which is threatening the life support system of this planet. Apart from these three major gases, the atmosphere also has some other gases like argon, helium, methane, etc. in small volumes. The water vapors and dust particles are the other important components present in the atmosphere. They have their own relevance. The water vapors are mainly concentrated near the oceanic floor as compared to the land area. The dust particles play a significant role in the process of condensation. These are also called the hygroscopic nuclei, as it provides a center around which a raindrop forms. Both the water vapors and dust particles are found in the lower layer of the atmosphere. Today's home assignment. First, how do plants absorb nitrogen? Second, what is the importance of carbon dioxide and oxygen for living beings? That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.